Bonjour, bienvenue. Les verbes pronominaux, pronominal verbs. Pronominal verb means pronoun added verbs. A pronoun is added with the infinitive of the verb. Pronoun added verbs or pronominal verbs. There are many verbs like se laver, se parler, se souvenir that are pronominal, and these verbs can be identified, can be recognized by the pronoun se, right in front of the infinitive, before the infinitive. This reflexive pronoun, sir, is called reflexive pronoun. This reflexive pronoun is a part of the infinitive with the meaning oneself or each other. Remember, this reflexive pronoun, sir, is mandatory in front of the base verb laver, parler, souvenir, etc. And this se is a part of the pronominal verb. Se takes the meaning of, takes the translation of oneself or each other, or in some verbs, it doesn't get any translation. It doesn't have any meaning at all. These pronominal verbs are classified into three categories. These verbs fall into three categories. Number one, they are reflexive. Reflexive verbs. These pronominal verbs function as a reflexive verb. What is a reflexive verb? The action the subject does is reflected on the subject itself. The subject does the action on the subject itself. We declare a pronominal verb as reflexive when the action done by the subject is reflected on the subject itself. For example, se laver, laver to wash, se laver to wash oneself. How do you conjugate je me lave? I myself wash. That is, I wash myself. The subject, is doing the action of washing. The action is done on me. I wash whom? I wash myself. So, the action of washing is reflected on the subject himself. Therefore, verbs like se laver that are pronominal falls under the category reflexive. Reflexive pronominal verbs. Pronominal verbs, and they are reflexive verbs. Reflexive pronominal verbs. The action is done on the subject itself. The subject is doing the action on the subject itself. The action is reflected on the subject. These verbs are called reflexive pronominal verbs. The second category of pronominal verbs is reciprocal. The first one is reflexive, second category is reciprocal verbs. Reciprocal verbs indicate an action done by two or more subjects on one another. Example, se parler. Parler means to speak. Se parler, to talk to each other. In the conjugation, we come across ils se parlent. They talk to each other. A boy and a girl. Boy talks to her and the girl talks to the boy. He talks to her and she talks to him. They talk to each other. He does the action of speaking to her and she does the action of speaking to him. Here, the action of speaking is not reflected but reciprocated. The subject does the action to another subject. Subject A does the action to B and subject B reciprocates the action to A. Pronominal verbs that indicate such reciprocated actions are said to be reciprocal pronominal verbs. Do note the difference between first category reflexive and second category reciprocal. In the first one, reflexive, I do the action on me. I wash myself. I wash myself. I do the action on me. In the second one, I do the action of speaking to you. And you do the action of speaking to me. It's reciprocated. The first one, it is reflected. Second one, it is reciprocated. First one, subject does the action on the same subject. But in the second one, subject does the action on another subject and that another subject does the action on the first subject. The third category of pronominal verbs is idiomatic pronominal verbs. These verbs with SE, the pronoun so, indicate an action which is neither reflexive nor reciprocal. In these pronominal verbs, the pronoun so, SE, is only a construction that doesn't take any special meaning. For example, we have ce souvenir on the screen. Ce souvenir is to remember. Conjugation, je me souviens. I remember, that's all. It's not I remember myself. No, I remember. Tu te souviens. You remember. Il se souvient. He remembers. This SE doesn't take any translation at all. It takes no special meaning as in the reflexive and reciprocal pronominal verbs. The conjugation of pronominal verbs in indicative present tense we learn in this class. Se laver. Se laver means to wash oneself. Laver, to wash. Se, reflexive pronoun oneself. So to wash oneself, we write the subject pronouns first. Je, tu, il, elle. Nous, vous, il, elle. Laver, regular ER group of verb. So remove the ending ER and add the endings LAVE for je, tu, LAVES, il, elle, LAVE, nous, LAVONS, vous, LAVEZ, ILS, ELLES, il, elle, LAVENT. Now, this reflexive pronoun, sir, it's getting manifested into m for je, me, love, tu, te, love, il, elle, se, love, nous lavons, vous lavez, il, se, love, elle, se, love. Je is the subject pronoun, me is the reflexive pronoun, and lave is the verb. So, the conjugation of se laver in indicative present affirmative form will be je me lave, I wash myself. Tu te laves, you wash yourself. Il se lave, he washes himself. Elle se lave, she washes herself. Nous lavons, we wash ourselves. Vous lavez, you wash yourselves. Il se lave, elle se lave, they wash themselves. You may wonder why there are two nous and two vous in the conjugation. Nous lavons, vous lavez. But please bear in mind, nous lavons, first nous is a subject pronoun, we. Second nous is the manifestation of se. Se becomes nous for nous. First nous is we and second nous is ourselves. Vous lavez. First vous is you and second vous is yourselves. The reflexive pronoun. The reflexive pronoun se becomes me for je, te for tu, se for il and elle, nous for nous, vous for vous, se for il, elle, ILS, ILLES. Je me lave. In French, it is written I myself wash. In English, it translated as I wash myself. That's the correct translation in English language. This is the pronominal verb conjugated in indicative present tense affirmative form. Negative form, ne pas is added. Ne is added after the subject. Je ne. Then you come across me lave. Then after the verb pas is added. So you get the construction je ne me lave pas. I do not wash myself. Tu ne te lave pas. You do not wash yourself. Make sure that you do not separate the reflexive pronouns sir and lave. Ma lav, to lav, so lav. Na comes even before ma, after j. Normally, na is written after the subject. Je ne. Pa is written after the verb. Lau pa. Je ne me lau pa. I do not wash myself. Tu ne te lau pa. Il ne se lau pa. Elle ne se lau pa. Nous lavons pas. Vous ne vous lavez pas. Il ne se lave pas. Elle ne se lave pas. This is the negative form of a pronominal verb in indicative present tense. Always write and practice all the content taught in every video class. In the interrogative form, we take the subject pronoun and write it after the verb. We get a question. First person singular, je alone, we add the interrogative expression est-ce. Now we get the complete interrogative form. Est-ce je me lave? Do I wash myself? Te laves-tu? Do you wash? Or do you wash yourself? Se lave-t-il? Does he wash himself? Se lave-t-elle? Does she wash herself? Nous lavons-nous? Do we wash ourselves? Vous lavez-vous? Do you wash yourselves? Se lave-t-il? Se lave-t-elle? Do they wash themselves? This is the interrogative form of the pronominal verb in indicative present tense. Don't get confused between two nous and two vous. Make sure of what is what. Subject pronoun and reflexive pronoun. A few examples of pronominal verbs category wise are given. The first one is reflexive pronominal verbs. Sasavuar, to sit. Sapale, to be called. Sahate, to stop. Sabhose, to brush. Sukushe, to go to bed. Sabiye, to dress up. So leve, to get up. So promene, to take a walk, to take a stroll. So reveille, to wake up. Second one is idiomatic pronominal verbs. Samuse, to enjoy, to have fun. So dépêche, to hurry up, to hurry. S'endormir, to fall asleep. S'ennuyer, to get bored, to be bored. Se fâcher, to get angry. Se marier, to get married. Se reposer, to rest, to take rest. Se sentir, to feel. Se taire, to be quiet, to be silent. The third one is reciprocal pronominal verbs. S'aimer, to love each other. Se détester, to hate each other. Se disputer, to argue. S'embrasser, to kiss. Se quitter, to leave each other. Se regarder, to look at each other. So Rotruve, to meet each other. So Telefone, to telephone to each other. Some sentences are given to read and understand. Lise e compone. 1. Raghu sollev. Raghu gets up. Il sollav. He washes himself. Mala sabhi lantuma. Mala dresses up slowly. Nous dépêchons. We hurry up. Raghu ye Mala se rencontre. Raghu and Mala meet each other. Les professeurs se parlent. The teachers speak to each other, talk to each other. Les enfants s'endorment. The children fall asleep. Mes parents se couchent. My parents go to bed. Je me fâche. I get angry. Vous mariez. You get married. Read these sentences twice or thrice for a better comprehension and try doing this exercise. 3 verbs are given, pronominal verbs. Seme, sahate, se repose. Seme, conjugate in affirmative form. Sahate, in the negative form. Se repose, in the interrogative form. Do not hesitate to go through this lesson if you have any doubts. With this, we complete this class. You may subscribe to this YouTube channel for the notifications of latest lessons. I take leave. We meet again. Thank you and bye-bye.